Hi everyone, my name is Laurencio, and in this super video I am going to speak about Prince of Persia games for Java.
First off, I want to tell you that the games are not necessarily in chronological order. Okay, so let's start with the list. First off, we have Prince of Persia: The Forgotten Sands. The game is a must play for Java out of many reasons. First off, the gameplay is fun and action-packed. You even have space for combat strategies. The game is not just mindless button smashing. You get to choose how you want to take on your enemies. And if we are at enemies, they are not really plenty. You get different type of enemies, is true, but mostly you will see the same skeletons and the same fat guy with an axe. But the magic of Prince of Persia: The Forgotten Sands lies in something else. It doesn't lie in how many different types of enemies you have, it lies on how many ways you have to kill your enemy. And here the magic of the game begins. You will take enemies on with your swords, with a giant axe, or rolling on a boulder. Shoot them down with a crossbow, take one of them by the legs and swing him into the other enemies, and many more. Aside from the small fry in the game, mostly skeletons, but you get birds, scorpions and others too. Anyway, aside from the minions, you have also boss battles, and prepare yourself for some epic battles. Here, boss battles are varied. Each boss has its unique way of fighting and unique abilities, and they are fun and are a little challenging too. Not really, but yeah, they are a little bit challenging, because after one or two attacks, you learn how to beat the boss. Also, there are tips on screen to know what to press against what attack. The boss battles and the combat in general is fun, because the game has nice and responsive controls. They just feel right, and the button mapping feels natural, and the frame rate is also good for a smooth gaming experience. The graphics are awesome for a Java game, having bright levels that are very nice to look at. During gameplay, aside from fighting minions and bosses, you also get to parkour to solve level puzzles that are actually fun to do, adding a lot of variation to the game. You even get running levels like this. Also, like in the big version of the game, you can use the sand ability to manipulate time, which will help you a lot during levels and in boss battles. I like that this game doesn't feel repetitive. It adds new things at the right intervals for the game to feel varied. The video is too short to show you each unique feature, but I totally recommend you the game. It's among the best games for the Java platform. Prince of Persia: Warrior Within is a fun Java game, with all the things needed to be fun. The combat is nice, even though you mostly just button smash. The parkour part can get a little challenging in some parts, not very difficult, but you'll have to repeat some jumps several times. The graphics look good and the levels are fun to parkour in. The game has fast-paced moments. This game also has an arena mode, where you can try to beat as many waves of enemies as possible. Next up is Prince of Persia 3: The Two Thrones, which looks a little bit downgraded graphically from the previous game, but maybe it's just me, or maybe I have a downgraded version, I don't know. Anyways, Prince of Persia 3 is a nice game from many aspects. The graphics are good for a Java game, you get the specific puzzle solving and parkour, the combat is also nice, and you get multiple enemies again. Also, the levels are varied. Like, for example, in one you fight a giant monster, in another you horse race, in another you do your typical parkour. The level designs look also good, with their bright colors. Another nice thing is that you can play with both the Prince and the Dark Prince, and each behaves differently from each other. Also, this game has a survival mode, and two different difficulty settings, normal and hard. Prince of Persia Classic is a Java game made in honor of the 1989 Prince of Persia game, which was later remade in 2007. The game respects the same rules, meaning you get to jump, pass through obstacles, sword fight, and more. I know that this is something the classical version had too, but the camera still bothered me. For example, in the first level, you can't really see where to go. The platform just moves away, but you can't see what's below. So you have the emotion that, what if I jump? Will I die, or is there something else? Is there something down below? I can't really see. It is a nice game strategy, but still the camera doesn't show enough. Another thing that bothered me was the unresponsive controls. If you run, you need to plan your stop, because at the end he does some extra steps. When you jump, you have to be careful because the controls don't make you feel safe that you will land the jump, and overall for me the controls felt clunky. Also, after completing a story level, your game progress saves and you can level select any level you want to repeat. And when repeating, you can choose between normal, classic, and time attack. But it is still a great game, with a solid gameplay, and it's a nice Prince of Persia experience on the go, especially if you are a fan and played the classic. Next up is Prince of Persia 2008, which is another strong title for the Java platform. This time, you play with two characters, with the prince in combat and in parkour, and from time to time the game switches to Elika, so that you can push a lever or something to get past the obstacles. The game formula is nice because it's varied. You have combat, parkour, puzzles, flying levels, and also there are a lot of things to do. For example, you can beat up funny looking and colorful monsters, or you have boss battles of many sorts. And each boss battle is unique in its way, so things won't feel repetitive. As for graphics and level designs, they are bright and nice looking. A problem I noticed though is that the game stutters. It might be just my phone, or it really is a problem from the developers, I don't know. Anyway, I recommend you the game because it has nice gameplay that will keep you interested. It is action-packed and it is varied, so it won't feel too repetitive. Thanks for watching, and if you're interested about more Prince of Persia games for Java, just click at the part 2 of this 2-part video.